So, you have stumbled across Tetris the Grand Master and want to play it, but don't know where to get it. I'll show you how to set up the three TGM games. Tetris the Grand Master, or TGM, Tetris the Grand Master, the Absolute Plus, or TAP, and Tetris the Grand Master Terror Instinct, or TI, so that you can start stacking. As each of these is an arcade game, the 100% authentic way of playing these is buying original arcade PCBs, which are quite expensive. For TGM PCB, you'd pay something like $300, around $700 for TAP, and something like $1,200 for TI. As this probably blows many people's budget, we'll make use of other ways. To play TGM and TAP, we can emulate the arcade games. To do this, use MAME, which stands for Multiple Arcade Machine Emulator. In theory, any version works, however, I'd highly recommend using an adapted version, Shoot 'em up MAME TGM, which contains patches to A. Decrease the input lag of TAP, B. Fix the frame rate of TAP, details follow, and C. Remove an annoying warning screen which pops up every time you start TGM. This version can be found at the link in the description below. Download it, place the .exe into an empty folder, and create a folder named ROMs, which stays empty for now. Now you need to download the actual game files. I won't provide links, but you should search for tgmj.zip and zpzn2.zip. In case you decide to use a newer main build for whatever reason, also download qsound.zip. As soon as you have found them somewhere, put the zip files into the ROMs folder without extracting them. When you start MAME now, the games show up in this list. To configure your controls, select Configure General Inputs and then Player 1 Controls. A long list of different inputs shows up, but the only relevant ones for TGM and TAP are up, down, left, right, and buttons 1, 2, and 3. Press Enter or double click and then a key to map it to the function. Other important functions are found in other controls, where one player start, coin 1, and service are the relevant ones. When you're done, go back to the games list and select TGMJ Tetris the Grand Master to load the game. The following screen gives some information about the emulated arcade machines if you're interested. Close it with a button press. Now the game boots. And that's it. Now you can play TGM. To start the game, insert the coin and start. Ready. Go. To ditch inserting a coin every time you want to play, you can enable free play mode. Press Service to open up the Service menu, navigate to Configuration, and then to System. Change the coin mode from 1 coin 1 play to Free play by going to the left once. Then leave by selecting Exit, and then Save and Exit. It saves the configuration, and then exit again. This restarts the machine. Now you don't need a coin anymore, and can start again by just pressing Start. To skip the opening screens after the test picture, press the Start button a few times. To access MAME settings during emulation, press Tab, where you can set machine-specific input settings, for example. To play TAP, download the tgm2.zip and the tgm2p.zip and put them into your ROMs folder. tgm2 only contains the base game, while tgm2p, P4+, contains the update which includes more game modes, for example. To play, start tgm2p Tetris the Absolute the Grandmaster 2+. You can see now that TAP runs at this weird frame rate of 61 point something frames per second. This originates from the hardware TAP runs on, but many other main builds play TAP at 60 FPS, which is 2-3% slower compared to the original. Fortunately, as mentioned before, this version of MAME takes care of that. Now wait a bit or spam buttons to skip some screens and you're done. To enable free play mode, again press Service, go to Game Setting, and change the coin mode to Free Play. Then exit twice and the game restarts. and that's how you get TGM and TAP going. TGM 3, or TI, is different from the previous ones due to the hardware it ran on, which used a special version of Windows XP embedded. This means that the game can be run on Windows natively using some tricks. To play it, first go on a hunt in the internet to find the game files, although Google usually shortens the process by a lot. As soon as you have those, download the altinput.zip, link in the description, which dramatically reduces input lag to make the game feel a lot more responsive. Extract it and drop its contents in the folder. To configure inputs and other settings, open the tgm3.cfg with the text editor of your choice. There you can adjust video settings, keyboard and joystick/controller inputs, and enable some practice options which are not relevant for the beginning. Most settings are self-explanatory, but to change the keyboard button assignments we'll have to use the website which is linked in the file. It contains a table of every key and the number beneath it. To assign a function to a key, copy the corresponding code into the line. After saving the file, start the game by launching the tgm3launcher.exe. Ready, go. But what if you have performance problems or don't like the idea of downloading ROMs? Fortunately, there's a TGM clone called Texmaster, which lets you play every available game mode except Sakura mode from TGM 3. You can download it here. To configure the key bindings, first open the Texmaster 2009.ini file and scroll to the keyboard section. Change the key type PL1 to 5 so that you can use a custom layout. To get these key codes, open the key.html within the HTML folder. Write the corresponding key codes beneath the button and save. Now you can use Texmaster to play TGM.
Termination.
If you don't like the default style and this one more instead, you can download the Terminal Velocity theme here. Extract the archive and drop the data folder into the Texmaster folder. When prompted where the file should be replaced, do so. Now Texmaster looks like this. Hope I could help, and start stacking.